Hello, I'm from Winnipeg, Manitoba, which is very far from France. And it's very interesting how from kindergarten I started to learn French little by little. And of course, when you're younger, your parents are really responsible for putting you in French immersion. But I really decided to stick with it because of the advantages and benefits that I have now as a bilingual, especially in Canada. So from kindergarten all the way until grade 12, I learned French. And in Winnipeg, they had a very good French immersion system in which all of our classes were in French, even gym, music, art, everything was in French except for English class. So even the English teachers I would call Madame, Madame. And I spent 13 years in that system in Winnipeg, and coming over to Ontario, I was still calling every teacher Madame in French until I realized that was not how it always was. And so I spent French immersion until grade 12. And in university, I went into psychology. And in second year, I realized that after 1 year, I was already starting to lose my French a little bit. And after 12 years, I thought it was important to keep up with it. I was open to many possibilities, like studying in France. Because of the program I was in, I got a lot of information about the Ontario Rhône-Alpes program that's available to Canadian and French students. So it facilitates an exchange between Canadian students here and French students in the Rhône-Alpes region. So basically, they send as many Canadians and French students that want to go across the ocean. And so at that point, I was able to go there and study for a year. And I studied all of my psychology classes in French. I studied French literature with actual French students. So that was a very different experience. And then I came back and finished my French and psychology degree. I realized that that was not the end of my French experience and that I could still gain a lot more from studying out there. So I went and did my master's for 2 years in Grenoble once again. And at that point, I did a master's in psychology and I was studying everything in French, and it really helped me to develop my capacity to comprehend everything that was in French, but also explain everything, because speaking about science is hard in itself, but speaking about it in another language is something else. So that really helped me learning everything, even learning psychology from a different perspective, because of course each laboratory also has their own experience, and I had a great experience there. I decided I wanted to do my PhD and that I wanted to do it in France, but I still wanted to come back here, and I thought the best compromise would be to do an international joint PhD, because then I am supervised by a supervisor in France, a supervisor in Canada, and we collaborate between the two labs to bring each lab's expertise together. So that really facilitates bringing a new and novel concept together when it comes to research. So now I'm currently doing my PhD in co-tutelle, or as we say, an international PhD, under the co-supervision of a lab in France and a lab in Canada. Studying in France is very different than studying in Canada, and there's always advantages as well as disadvantages, and it's just about learning how to adapt to each system. So when I studied in France, I was doing first an exchange, and that was very easy because you go to the university, they have a lot of international students in Grenoble, so the system is very easy to navigate through, surprisingly, and you are very easily welcomed. And the courses, the professors are always very accommodating when it comes to international students as well. When it came to my master's program, so I was studying alongside alongside other French students. I was no longer an exchange student, so I was put on the same level as the French students. And it's a very different system because you are only evaluated once a year, so you only have one final exam to study for. So throughout the year, you are not necessarily as busy because you don't have as many homework assignments to do, as many papers to write for classes as you are in Canada. So the advantage of that is that you have more time to dedicate towards your research. You attend lecture, but other than that, there's not much additional work that you have to do. So this allows you to give a lot more time towards your research and to be able to produce perhaps more research. When it comes to the student life on university, it's very different as well. So a big advantage is it's basically free to study in France. So if you're kind of hesitating, you're not, in Canada, that is a big difficulty that lots of students face, is paying for tuition. In France, you don't have to worry about that as much, and you're able to take advantage of everything that the school has to offer. They have lots of electives that are not necessarily the same of what we have out here. And it's overall a very different experience, but it's a very beneficial experience, and you just have to learn how to adapt to the different system and take advantage of the differences. So I don't know anyone that wouldn't necessarily want to go, and it is always the aspect of, do I have the time, do I have the money to go? So as a student, I would say just go. It is the best time that you will have the best opportunity right now to go as a student and to study out there. Not only will you learn a lot from your classes in France, but you will also learn a lot from the culture. And going as a student on exchange, there is lots of grant money that is available, lots of scholarships through various programs like the Ontario Rhone Alps program. Universities also offer scholarships to go. So financially, it's not as difficult as one might think. If you want to go not on exchange, it still is not financially as difficult as you might think, because when you go to study in France, we don't have the same tuition fees. And even if you have to pay to get there and to live, it's the same finances that we have here in Canada, and the experience is just so much more. So studying in France is definitely something that I would encourage, because the French culture is very unique. You will not get that experience anywhere else. And studying there is easy, and it is something that I think that any student who is willing to do it should definitely just take the jump and go, because it will be the best time of your life, maybe, and you will be a very different person afterwards, but for the better.